Hello and welcome to Proton Essentials, my dear feathered friends, a new Boon Guide episode. For those who are new, the Boon Guide is an umbrella project covering various topics around Linux. It aims to help you new and advanced users to get into Linux and to provide a good starting point to move on in your Linux journey on your own. Today I cover some basics around Proton and a few terms which you might hear often. What is Proton? Proton is a compatibility layer based on Wine, which is made for Linux and Unix-based operating systems to allow for execution of Windows applications including games on your computer. By this, it does not emulate an entire Windows operating system and no virtual machines are involved, but instead translate Windows system calls to Linux and Unix. Or in other words, it's a Windows to Linux translator. Furthermore, Proton is integrated into the Linux Steam client and has a few additions compared to the Wine project. The main goal is to allow you to seamlessly play your games you would otherwise only be able to play on Windows on Linux via Steam. Also, it aims to avoid any sort of manual configuration and intervention by the player, so you just hit install and play as you would normally do and Proton takes care of everything else. Valve, the developers of Steam and Proton, also have a whitelist for games they tested using Proton and confirmed working. Those are available in your Steam library on Linux right away alongside with your Linux native games, and you would not notice that Proton is used to play those games. Enable Proton for all titles. Unlike with whitelisted games, Steam will not allow you to install and play games via Proton, which are untested and therefore not listed inside your library. But you can configure your Steam client to show and execute those as well. To allow Proton for all your games, you just need to do one little change. Navigate to Steam, Settings, Steam Play, and there you find two checkboxes. Enable Steam Play for supported titles, this option might already be enabled, and enable Steam Play for all titles. This will also enable a drop-down menu in which you can choose which version of Proton is to be used for untested games by default, if not specified otherwise, on a per-game basis. Steam Play is here the overall term for anything related to Proton and other compatibility layers such as Boxrun or Lux Torpedo. Activate both settings and restart Steam. Now you should be able to install and play any game in your library on Linux unless it is not working due to other reasons. ProtonDB. If you are uncertain if a certain game might run at all, or if you might need to take some inconvenience into account, you can check out for compatibility reports on ProtonDB. ProtonDB is a community-driven webpage where you can find compatibility reports by other players. This also might include some tweaks to be made to some games to work if the game is not working out of the box anyway. Alongside this, you can also see which version of Proton was used by the reporter and on which Linux distribution the game was run. But being a community-driven page, reports over there are also to take with a little bit of salt, since not everyone is obviously a Linux and Proton guru and people make errors from time to time. To overcome this shortcoming, ProtonDB has a rating system, which rates the game in different tiers. Borked, it won't run at all. Bronze, it works, somehow, but a lot of inconvenience, stutter, instability, or a lot of tweaking and configuration might be necessary in order to run the game. Silver, those games might run noticeably better, but still have some flaws or require some more tweaking. Gold, often requires only some minor level of tweaking such as game launch parameters, but then should run just very decent. Platinum means the game just works out of the box, no issues are to be expected, no tweaks are necessary and the performance is also very good. Native. Games marked as native do offer a Linux version and therefore should run just fine as well. Wine AppDB. If Proton might lack reports about a certain game, or you seek for compatibility reports about a non-Steam game and applications, you can also check out the Wine AppDB, which is similar to ProtonDB, has the same rating system, and is community-driven as well. Or better said, ProtonDB works and has the same rating system as Wine's AppDB because it was there first and a long time before Proton was even a thing. Select a Proton version per game. In case you encounter a Linux native game with some issues and you want to try out the Windows version instead using Proton, or you've read reports that a certain game does only run with a certain version of Proton, you can easily tell Steam on a per-game basis which version of Proton to use. For this, open up the game's library page and navigate to Settings, Compatibility. There you will find a checkbox for the specific Steam Play compatibility tool for this title. And after ticking it, you will see a drop-down menu of all available versions of Proton, and you are free to choose any one of those. But usually it should suffice to go with the latest one. In case of a native Linux game, Steam will now download the Windows files of this game. The amount of data needed are dependent on the game. Outro. By the way, in case of native games on Linux requiring tweaks, or if you might be better advised to run the Windows version via Proton or Wine, we also have a dedicated video series for this, called Linux Native. Feel free to check it out as well. Now you should be well suited for your first steps in Linux gaming and Proton. If you wish to get more insights on this, feel free to check out our next episode on this, in which I will go a little bit deeper into the topic and explain various terms you might encounter while proceeding in your Linux gaming journey. That's it for today's video, and I wish you a lot of fun with Proton.